she came home.
Carlyle's lost an empire. You fall hard enough, you tend to be reminded of what truly matters. So, the end of the line. You ready for this?
Are you? Who will you be without a score to settle?
I guess the world's most wanted fugitive will have to do.
Alexa Carlyle is dead, according to the funeral invitation, that is. So naturally, it caused quite a stir when the late matriarch turned up at the breakfast table, alive and kicking. Carlyle, wisely sensing that her number is up, has emerged from exile to tie up loose ends and secure the Carlyle legacy. She may be a monster, but you have to admire her due diligence. Carlyle descends from an ancient line of warrior aristocrats. Her great-grandfather made a killing in the Second Opium War and established an empire in shipping, railroads, and newspaper publishing. While largely unknown to the public, the family still asserts its quiet dominance over global transport and logistics, media, and technology. Most senior of the partners, Alexa Carlyle, is cold as ice, tough as nails, and sharp as a razor. Incidentally, it was her late father who first brought the three families together after the end of World War II at this very house, meaning that this gentleman is the birthplace of Providence.
It began here, and it ends here. Talk about poetic.
One more thing. According to our intel, Carlyle keeps a case file on the Constant, information that may be helpful in his recapture, so don't leave the estate without it.
Right. Happy hunting, 47. See you on the other side.
Thornbridge Manor. The Carlyle family's home for countless generations. The Revenant Alexa Carlyle and her three adult children, younger brother Zachary, grandson, and daughter-in-law, are all gathered to conduct Carlyle's sham funeral. Curiously, Carlyle summoned a famous London PI soon after arriving this morning, but his purpose at Thornbridge is yet unclear. Now, the target knows that you're coming, and her guard detail is top-notch. So Mr. Gray will secure their nearby field HQ and intercept all calls going in and out of the estate. Any appeal for backup is going to fall on very deaf ears. Good luck, gentlemen.
Phineas Whitmark, private investigator. I have an appointment with Madame Carlyle.
Please wait. Mr. Whitmer is here to see Madame Carlyle. You can go right in.
Mary fainted when she heard Madame Carlyle was still alive. She didn't even see it herself. It was Fernsley who told her.
I can believe that. What a surprise.
And the family has to pretend she's still dead. Some of them are not happy about that at all.
Junior calling from Morgan, Yates, and Cohn. I need to get a listing of asset transfers from the Carlyle account. 5085. No, I need it immediately.
Yeah,
doesn't exist. What do you mean it doesn't exist? I'll double check and get back to you.
Dig this place. Ancestral graveyard, trophy room, and the office safe is hidden behind a portrait with a secret mechanism for uncovering.
Peculiar icons above the safe. I wonder if they might be some sort of a code. Maybe have a look around the office, 47. A safe in Madame Carlyle's office. I bet that's where she keeps the file on Arthur Edwards. Good work, 47. That's the file on Arthur Edwards secured. Time to take care of Madame Carlyle.
I doubt our big brother could have botched it up any worse than I have, even if he'd tried.
Mission complete. Well done, 47.
They're everywhere. Go, get out! It's the Constantine! Shit!
Thank you, Miss Burnwood. Now, it's my turn.
Stay down. Boss wants you alive.
Yeah?
How about now? Over here! Cover me! Walk away!
Or what? You gonna take us all on?
Don't.
Yeah!
Tell the Constant to start running!
You think you've won? 47 is out there. And 47 never misses his mark.
Neither do you, Miss Burnwood. That's what makes you valuable.
You're delusional. You think I would betray 47?
Trust me. You owe him nothing.
What is this?
I told you we could help each other. And I meant it. I look forward to your call.
Gray is gone. Go to Berlin and stay out of sight. We're all that's left